In this vlog, we are going to see how to send an in-app message to our Flutter application using OneSignal. So previously, we have seen in-app message using Firebase. In this particular tutorial, I'm providing the link in the description section below. And now, we are making use of OneSignal to send an in-app message, which looks similar to that of our previous tutorial, but here we are having more number of options as we are making use of OneSignal. Yes, as we go through this particular tutorial, I'm going to show you what are all the different options we have in sending in-app messaging, and I'm pretty much sure that you would be opting OneSignal instead of sending in-app message directly from Firebase. And yes, of course, OneSignal is also making use of Firebase, but it is providing us a very good user interface so that we can make our work as simple as posting an image on Facebook message so that we can explore all the available options in app. So the very first thing is like message name. You can also save, you can also create a template of your own. So this I'm just naming like first in app. And by the end of this template here, you are having an option like save as draft. So this particular template will be saved by this name first in app. And also you are having an options like show to all users, show to a particular users, that is segments. So how to create a segments and what are the segments and how we can create segments. So I will do an in detail tutorial on this particular segment topic. Just let me know in the comment section below if you are interested. And here the second option is like message. How do you want to design your message? So there are two options provided for you. First one is a block editor and the second one is a HTML editor. So in the start of the tutorial, I just said you, right, using OneSignal, you are having more options and it's easy to use as well. So when you tap on HTML editor here, you will be provided with the code option here. So you can just write the code like, and you can also see the output on the right hand side, like how the in-app message will look like. So if you are having a good knowledge on HTML, you can just get started with this particular block of code. And as this is a basic tutorial, I'm going to cover block editor. So block editor is nothing but the basic way of customizing our in-app message. And just let me know in the comment section below. I will also try to show an example like how HTML editor works if you are really interested and want to try it. In the block editor, we are being provided with some basic options like, so how you want to position your in-app message in your screen. So the first option is top here, and when you select top here, it will be like a top banner in your application, and center, bottom, and this is a full screen. And again in full screen, you are having two options like with margin and without margin. So with margin looks pretty much good for me. And let's try to select full screen here and also with margin. And here in the text, I'm going to specify Flutter app. And in the fonts, I'm going to select Fira Sans. And for format, I'm going to select bold here. And whenever you select any particular option, you can see like your screen is getting reloaded on the right side so that you can get the exact output like how it looks in your mobile application. And the color, black color is good for me. And font size is, you can just select anything. I think 24 is better. And text align is also center, it works for me. And here even you have advanced options like margin to the top, right, bottom and left. You can specify margin to all the sides of your particular text here. So by default it is like 0, and you can just specify them if you require them. So here I have specified 100, so my text moved from top by 100 pixel here. So in this way it works, but for me by default 0. And here image, you can also add an image over here, and this is a default image added by OneSignal. And you can also add a click action for your image. So whenever user taps on this particular image, what action needs to be performed. Like, do you want to open a URL or you want to push a permission prompt? Like, in general, when you are dealing with the application, there will be a permission prompt. Like, so in this way, a location permission prompt, and also you can add a custom action ID. And with the help of this particular custom action ID, you can define your own functionality in your app level and make it work. Okay, so I'm going to select URL here, and also you need to specify URL in this particular format here. You should not miss HTTPS or anything like that. And I'm going to specify my website here. And as we have already selected URL here, so we need not again reselect anything. And for this particular block also, we have advanced options, which is just like margin on all the sides and also dismiss on click. So I'm not going to select this particular dismiss on click for now. And here we also have a button which is not visible here, but yes, there is a button also here. So I just want to make the button margin like 100 here from bottom, so that my button will be just below the image. And also for the button, you are having various options like click me. So let's make it get started. And also font Fira Sans again, and remaining all the things are pretty much perfect. And close button, so here we also have a close button, and you can just add height and width for it. So the button looks good, and also just make it like 10 and 10 only. And here also we have got some advanced options like margin, and finally we have got background here. So what is the background color currently is like white color. You can just make it any other color as well. So let's go with white color itself. And also you have got an option like portrait or landscape. So these are all the various options when you are making use of OneSignal here. So for now, portrait is my requirement. So, and these are the triggers. When should users see this message on app open? When certain conditions are satisfied? And again, what are these conditions? So we can just specify some conditions, like when the user is in particular screen or particular action is performed. So we'll be discussing them more in a detailed tutorial. You need to just let me know in the comment section below, like what part of the tutorial you are very much interested. So I would be making a separate tutorial on it. So in this particular tutorial, just I want to cover all the basic aspects and try to get the output so that you will understand the basic functionality, and in coming tutorials we can implement much more things added on this particular basic functionality. And when should the message dismiss? Show until dismiss, so this is the best option. And dismiss after a certain amount of time, and you can also specify this if you just want the message to be displayed for a particular amount of time. So I'm going to stick with show until dismiss. And these are all the schedule options. Now I just want my message to go immediately, and you can also specify some time. So sometimes there will be offers in your application, so you can just specify the time exactly, like 12 o'clock in the midnight, so you are just going to start this particular offer. And in the scenarios, you can just specify specific time here. And also you got stop showing time here. So you just want the offer, or you just want the in-app message to be displayed only for 1 day or 2 days, or within a time range, or within a particular range, you can just specify them accordingly here. And how often do you want to show this message? This is also based on your requirement. If you just want to show only once, you can just specify once and every time. And now we almost reached the end of the template here, and I'm going to send this particular template now. So send test in app, and this is my device, and I'm going to send this particular in-app message. And here you can see we have got our in-app message as quickly as we tap on the send button.